the mechanism of how to really have a system to be dual bit. And maybe Suri, in a day or two, you would be doing that part. So let us move further and really talk about the things that we discussed in the previous session. So what we said in previous session was, like, we talked about the size, okay, and we are going to address that part probably in next session. But like, I am going to add some more information with respect to this data and bases part in today's session. So what we did yesterday was, we declared some global variables, then we initialized them, some of them were uninitialized, and accordingly we saw the elements or the variables are distributed in different sections, correct? Now, how exactly the system stores information? Because if you recall, while I took the code, so let me show you that code again. While I took the code, I said that local variables, this is a local variable, every local variable is stored in the stack. Now I should prove that, correct? How exactly I am going to prove it? So it may not be done in a session or so, but we will be taking few more sessions again, like while addressing that part after a while. But let me try to show you now, like, information about this, these all variables will be stored, and information of this will not be available with us right now. When we execute the code in memory, this information will be available at the latter stage. But right now, the information would not be available for this variable I. Now let us try to see how exactly this is organized. So what we did yesterday was, we compiled the code, okay, like this. Okay, we created an exe, fine, and with 32-bit, like whatever the regular pattern that we are assuming. So if our machine is 64-bit, then we don't write anything there. Ultimately, by default, takes 64. And then we saw magic number 2, okay, of the file. What command we use there? So read elf-e, and then we set my exe. So one can see that this information is available. Okay, and size of the header in this case for our exe is 64 bytes. Now there are few other important elements too. Where are they? All of them ultimately.
Sir, we are unable to see the terminal.
Sir, we can't see your screen, sir. It's not visible.
As you may have shared it, but I haven't clicked that one. Now, is it visible?
Yes.
Okay. So, what we tried was, like, what I was telling is, like, when we saw this code, okay, we wrote this dash M32, correct? And then we generated the thing. And even while, if I don't specify this dash M32, then by default it will be generating it and a 64-bit file. Okay. And what we could see that, like, we tried finding out information about header as well as magic number. So we applied this command. Then we got this magic number, as well as we got to know that size of this header is 64-bit. So every file will have some number of bytes reserved, which would be containing information about that magic number. Okay, and few other information which needs to be stored with the header. Fine. Now let us move further. Now whenever we write a code, that code ultimately contains user-defined variables. And subsequently I said that when you declare n variables, system or compiler at the time of creating object code with help of AS, GAS, GRU assembler, may create in turn multiple variables. So when I showed you this dash capital S, we got to know that there are, so let me say less. So in this case, you may see like my variables are declared here. J, K, M, N, O, P, correct? But the variable that I declared there as I is not seen, correct? So what I will do is I will write this M32 so that it would be better for your understanding. Yeah. So these were the my variables J, K, M, N, O, correct, and P. Now if I see, I was talking about a local variable. So this was your local variable. Correct. And if you recall, when we see the code less 220621.c, we declared this with 10. Correct? We declared it with value 10. We initialized it. So if I see in the code, I can see that the 10 value was assigned somewhere here. Correct. So let me make it 20. So I will make it that now 20 so that we can see at this point, at this particular place, that 10 is added. Okay, now let us make the change. I am using the same code and I am making that 10 to 20. Okay, now rest of the other variables are having initialized value of 10. Correct. So let me again get my assembly code, other output of compiler. Correct. Okay. So now let us see this code. I, J, K, we will see 10, 10 value for each of them. J, K, M, N, O, P. Each one is having 10, size of each is 4 bytes. Correct. Now let us go here. 20 is the value that we assigned. So you can see earlier it was 10, correct? Now one can see that it is 20. Now how many registers are there my Intel architecture? Like you must have seen in your CO course or maybe systems 1 course, like architecture can have multiple set of registers. Now how many registers my processor is supporting? Okay, so I will be exploring, or I will be communicating, or I will be telling you each register one by one. But right now, let us see how many can be seen here. So one can see this is ESP, this is stack pointer, this is EBP, this is base pointer, this is EAX, what you call as accumulator, correct? And other registers are not used in this case. And other registers are not used. These are our local variables, which are not created by us, but created by system. Every variable which starts with dot would be an internal variable. Now, you must have seen, like when you write printf call, okay, so let me write man printf. Recall, have I showed you man, by the way? Yes, correct? We saw this man. Am I right? So with this, there are these different, this man means manual. Okay, manual, like I am trying to see manual of man command, manual command. So these are the sections, correct? So if I write man, say ls, ls is the shell command or user command, correct? So you may see here when written. So if I go to man, you can see the section. What one section one says? It is executable program or shell command. Now let us talk about, we importantly would be addressing first three, okay, in this course, or for or at least for few lectures we are going to address these three. Rest of the others you may see later, probably if you do a specialized course related to maybe advanced operating system. Okay, right now we are not addressing that. Okay, now if I write, like you use printf function, correct? Am I right? You must have seen. So if I write printf, so is this the syntax of my printf? No. So this is printf of shell command. Now what I want to see is, I want to see a printf function of C library. Correct? C library. How can I get it? So let us go again back to man and let us see third. What it says? Library calls. Functions within program libraries. So if I write now man 3 printf. Now this is our printf function. Right, now see how many variants of printf are there. I assume most of you must have used only first two. Right? Rest you may not probably. But if you really are working on system level, you may require most of these remaining ones. Okay, and they are used for specific purposes. Now you may say that this number 3 represents that it is programmer manual. And only programmers, what are the functions that programmers are supposed to make use of, information or manual of those can be seen using this one parameter. Okay, similarly, now suppose, let me show you one command for a while, about which I am going to talk detail later, but I am only introducing it right now. There is a command called sprace. Now, how many programming languages are there on the Linux machine? Or probably Windows machine? Sanders, correct? Most of them are having print function. Am I right? Now, if print function is there for every language, now see, for example, if I am a person, okay, who knows very specific languages. Now, let us say we all are there, like, considering your class size to be 60. Can you assure that everyone speaks same language? Mother tongue of everyone is same? No. But if you want to communicate to me few things, for example, let us say somebody is from Kolkata, and he or she is trying to communicate me something in his or her mother tongue, will I be able to understand that? So there should be a translator. Now, if programming languages are in multiple number, when we say machine language code, how this translation should be done? So we will require specific translator for every language. But everything should be at same level. Whatever translation made should be at same level. So how should I do that? How can I achieve that goal? So what happens is, with bare hardware, like for example, if you consider my laptop, this is a bare hardware, correct? Now if I wish to install my OS, I install it, and OS will be a mediator between my program and the hardware. Now whatever instruction I will give, same should be understood by my machine. Now that mechanism is created by my translator through the operating system. Now whenever I use printf, printf for programmer's manual. So this printf is for C. If I use C++, then it will be cout. If I use say Java, there will be some other print function. Python, another print function. Syntax is going to vary across the different languages. Even while you use Gopher in previous semester, or Haskell probably, so you must have seen there is also a printf function available. Now, if all these languages are going to have that printf function, how my system is going to understand? So every print function will be converted to something called as system call. Or in Windows terminology, you call it as interrupt. Correct? System call or interrupt. So if I want to see what system calls are used when my program got executed. Now see, when I write this /whatever, I was asking, like I asked this question in previous class too. Like when I write this /whatever, what should happen? The program should get executed. But how? What should I do to achieve this goal, to execute this code as an operating system? Now think of this. Suppose we are in physical class in the classroom. Classroom has nearly 60 benches and your class strength suppose is 100. And we have seen probably that every time on an average 70 people attend the class. Now, can you assure that everyone, like when he or she enters in the class, will be occupying the benches in a serial order? No, it will be random. Whatever bench that you like, wherever you are feeling, you will try to occupy that place, correct? Now suppose you enter after 5 minutes. And then what you do? when you are at the door, you try to find out where is the free space available. So somebody should communicate you, you are going to that particular place. Now if it is a small classroom of size 60, it is good. You think of an auditorium, nearly 500. Will you be able to easily identify the vacant place? No, somebody should be there to guide you. Now in theaters, you must have seen there is a person always, when movie starts, and we have seen that majority of people do join after a while when movie starts, and they create obstacles in front of us. Now, there is somebody who directs them. So we should have some mechanism which will direct this code to get loaded in memory, how it is done. So let me show you how many different system calls are entered, used there. Correct. So I am writing express. So let me first write man express. So this is a command, okay, general command, which is used to trace system calls and signals. Correct. System calls and signals. So let us try to see how can I use this. So you write express and your executable name. So we took myexe, correct, 32-bit. So if I write this, okay, then let me take that earlier code, okay, gcc-m32-21-06.c. Okay, let me take this code, because we had printf there, correct, we wrote this printf statement, and in our yesterday's program, we never took printf. Okay, now this is there. So let me write stress.slash/whatever. So our target was to print hello students. Okay. So as a rare programmer, what you will say? I am only printing hello students. But now see what operating system have to do to only display your printer statement. Whatever string that you said, hello students, to display it, what efforts are to be put, what efforts are to be made by this particular statement. So let me write this. Now you will see that, let us start to see, can we see our hello students there? Yeah, this is hello students. Now what is used there internally? Write. There is something, one or so on. And if I count characters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So this write returns me how many characters are printed. So each thing here, you may see, like before the bracket starts on every line, then every line, because some of them may take 2 lines. For example, this taking 2 lines. But everything that you see here, before the opening bracket starts, each of them is called a system call. Now let me show you Dr. half of it.
Okay.
So let me redirect this output to a file. Let us see if we can get that. No, it will not show that. Okay, so let me minimize this. I will maximize it for a while. Yeah, so you may see here. Okay, let me write this. Is it visible? Yeah, so when we wrote this express a.out, it says execute the file with this name. This is starting address. Okay. Then assign a process ID to it. And then go on. Like it is time finding out memory location or memory address where this program should be loaded. Correct. So BRK. Each one of them is used internally. And then later, when everything is done, actually here everything is done, then it executes your code. And when that code got executed, it terminates the code by 0. Right, so each of them, which is used internally here, will be system call. About which we are going to see in detail later. Don't worry if you are not understanding what is happening. But let me help you in a more way. So Emax, I will take the same code. So we took printf. So let us say integer I. I'm writing scanf %d and %i semicolon, and I'm saying printf slash n value is %d I. So I have printf, I have scanf, I have printf. So printf, it is a C function, correct? Would we convert it to a system call? Scanf is a C function. Would we convert it to a system call? And let us see what it does. So let me translate this code. GCC dash M32210601.c. Okay. So at least warnings are there because we haven't included stdio.h and so on. So let us execute now stress dot slash dot. Now you will see that it will first print the statement and will wait for the input. So if I write this, you will see it is waiting for my input. So when I give input and press enter, it displays next value. Correct. So same thing, like it should wait for me now after printing this hello students. It should wait for me. So let us check it. Stress dot slash dot out. Is it waiting? Waiting for my input. Now my scanf was converted to a system called read. And there, like you can see, with write it was 1, with read it is 0. So if I give input, like for example 5, and if I press enter, now see, this 5 was taken and this is included in double quotes. What double quotes means for you in C language or in any language, what double quote, whatever is included inside a double quote, what it communicates as?
It is a string.
String.
The string. But we give what? Number. And it is displayed as string. Even you may see this 5 was included as a part of string, so it is not distinguishing it as a number. See, like when we do talk about this integers too, integers from 0 to 9 with decimal number 15. Every programming book, or rather let me say in first year of your bachelor's or whenever you started learning computers, you were told about ASCII characters, correct? What 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 9 included there in the ASCII character set? Yes or no? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Are they part of ASCII characters? Yes. Capital A was 65. Small a was 97. Maybe 0, 1, 2, 3. They might be starting from 45. So they are ASCII characters. That means what? Whatever I type here, like when I type 9, it says what? It assumes that this is a string, this is a character. It doesn't say that this is a number. So my system never understands number. My system, when I say my system, ultimately any system which is a computer can understand only characters, which in turn are converted to integers. That's why when we gave 5, it took it as a string. And you may see how many characters it took, 5 and slash n, two characters. So if I again execute it, and if I write 50, how many characters are taken? You may see here, 5, 0 and slash n, 3. So for it, there are three characters, 5, 0 and slash n. For you, what you gave input as 50. Are you with me? Everyone? Yes, please.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Okay. So, this 50 is not a number for it. The 50 is a string for it. But for you as a user, it is what? It is what? A number. Now let us try to see what exactly this read and write is trying to tell us. Now if I had not read, see, it added this 2. Linux programmer manual. See, read from a file descriptor. Now see what it contains. Read function. This is FD. Okay, let me ask you a funny question. Those who wrote file programs in C language, probably in their bachelor's or probably even for practice purpose, what is FP for you? FP?
File pointer.
Why you took FP only? Why not? Why haven't you took file I?
Maybe just habit.
Just a variable, correct?
Yeah.
But again, thanks to connector. Because we said FP should be there. And that's why we said file pointer. So in Unix terminology, or the start, from the start, when they came up with C language, Dennis Ritchie and his team, this FD was included. Now when you say scanner, how will you explain scanner? What scanner does? Why scanner is used?
To take inputs.
From?
User.
User. So if I am user, if I say, okay, you are asking, other system you are asking me the input, I said, yes, I have given. What will you do? It would not be that one, eh? It would be what? It would be?
Assigning the value to the integer or the any variable.
From standard input device. Input is taken from input device. That is the reason why we are taught input devices, output devices in our introduction to computer skills, correct? Now, yes. If it is not taken, now what is FD is displayed? If you recall, when we saw this read and write, what is shown there? Read content 0, write content 1. So what exactly they mean to us? So 0 is stdin and 1 is stdout. Standard output device, standard input device. Where can I find this? Okay, this would be our target. Like we will try to find out it, about it. Okay, so have you understood that there are system calls internally? Your code is converted to, then you call it as machine code. But ultimately, there are functions which are system calls. Like this, brk. So whatever you write, suppose you write brk here. So it says 2. You may say this. Change data segment size. It is for memory access. There is brk, there is sbrk even. So if you take this fstat64. Man, F stat 64. So this is a function. Correct? Stat function. 2. Okay. Get file status. Even if I talk about mprotect. These all are system calls. You may see that they all are from Linux programmer manual. Set protection on a region of memory. Now you must have seen, I don't know, like at least as you have sat together for a class, but recall your bachelor's course, when you attended physically the class. Now few students were always there who used to always occupy first bench. Correct? Have you seen that? For you, it, most of you rather, I am not saying all because some of you might be intelligent, maybe all of you. But I always used to occupy bench from last 3 to 4 rows. Sometimes last only. Correct. Now, this was like, okay, even our teacher used to recognize us. Okay, where are the LLBs? Last of last bench. He always used to remember us. Where are they? If one of us is not there in the class. But for the first benches, like, Some people do it, they try, like if I am a teacher and if it is a classroom, so I always teach to a corner, a person sitting in that corner, I always see towards him. Okay, so this is protected region. Okay, or sometimes what I do, I move my eyesight from left to right, then right to left, left to right, then right to left, like a CCTV. And everyone argues that I am seeing you. But rather, how exactly can we do that? So I need to define my space, and that's what will be defined by this. Where to start, where to stop, what is the limit? Okay, so majority of such functions are taken care internally whenever you load your executable. Okay, so this is like important command that we saw was express. And you may not load all system calls. How can I know how many system calls are there? Okay, so let me show you. Note down the path with assumption that you have Ubuntu. Okay, if you have different operating system, path may vary. Okay. So let us try, if you are using laptop, try with me. So go to USR, include, at least this would be same for each one of us, no matter which operating system, variant of Linux you are using. Okay, it could be Ubuntu, Debian, whatever, but most of you would be having this. So you should find this ASM directory. Okay, go there, and then you see this. So now let me write university_32.h. So we are talking about 32 bit code, correct? So these all are your system calls. So we saw write, correct? We saw read, I showed you fork, even we saw exec ve, correct? Even LSEQ was there. See, how many of them are there in 32 bits? So let me go below. Nearly 435. And they keep changing this depending upon the updates that come. Okay, if I remove this 32 and if I add 64, numbers are changed, order of calls is changed. Okay, and now see the count, same number, nearly 435. Only order of calls or order of this to change. So what is the path? So USR include ASM, correct, and the file called university_32.h. Is it okay? Yes, note it down. Could you see this? Now those who are not having this ASM directory in include can find something like 3i386 or something like this, a directory name with this name. Okay, instead of this ASM, it depends. Okay, shall I move further?
So like Linux and Windows must be having different system calls.
In Windows we call system calls, in Windows we call interrupts. The path would be different, path may not be same. So you need to search into, like Windows directory structure is very very different. And most of the things are hidden in Windows, they are not shown to you.
Yeah.
You may have to take help of various Windows internals books or maybe some sites, websites, okay, where they do have this information.
Sir?
Hey.
Does are they written in C?
Which one?
Yeah, the system calls.
Yeah, everything is written in C, like whatever you see on your machine right now. Almost all of them are written in C language. What are the programs? Your programs. Like see, suppose you are using Python. Python itself is created in C. So if you use Java, Java itself was created in C. Correct?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So this is the case. Yeah. Any other question? Shall I move further? Okay. Now we wanted to see now what exactly, how exactly we got those numbers for 0 for STDIN and 1 for STDOUT. I want to see this number. How can I get it? So let us see unistd.h. Okay. So I took unistd.h. Okay. So I'm not going to take that from ASL, but I am going to write it here in include. Okay. Go below. Yeah. Now see these file descriptors. Can you see them? Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what are the numbers? Standard file descriptor stdin is 0, stdout is 1, and std error. If no 0, no 1, then problem, then 2. So which we generally don't use, but the device driver programmers do write it. Okay, so let me add this in chat window so that you can check it. One minute. Okay, so so we saw now 0 and 1 for standard input and standard output. So we should be able to see my screenshot. Can you see that? At the window, you can check it. So what was the path? Slash USR. Let me write. Slash USR. Slash include. So it gives you that unistd.h file. Okay, any question, Rishikesh? Yeah, any question? Rohit, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, now, so what we saw, if my code is written, to execute my code, what operating system is supposed to do? But now somebody, like, what information other than this should go to the system? So if you recall, yesterday I asked you a question, okay, which I asked you to find out answer for. Which of the function get executed when you execute an executable created using GCC? Yeah, so can you answer that?
Probably main function, I think.
Okay, main function. Thank you, Sankhya. Anybody? How many of you think main? So I'm raising my hand because I also assume main function is the function which gets executed. So those who think main is the function can raise their hands. Okay. Good. So others are not okay. Seems everyone agrees with this. Because, yes, it is. That's how we were told. Now I'm raising down my hand. The reason behind, like if I said, like how many of you don't think main is the function, then I may not have raised the hand. So that means, so even you might not have raised the hand, but let me tell you, main is not the first function which gets executed. How the system will be communicated that you have to find out main in my code? Somebody should be there to find out it. Correct. Now suppose if I have to find out who are the placer members from this batch. So I need to ask somebody, I need to remember. If I don't remember, then I will ask, okay, CR, can you tell me who are your placements and members representing the placer? Correct? So that is an execution point for me, starting point for me. You can roll down the hands now. Now, if it is the case, which is the function then which gets executed? Now I am talking in general, no matter whether you are using Turbo C or Glue Compiler. Or even
loader will be executed.
Loader will execute, but loader is a code, correct? loader is a code itself. Which is the function written in loader? What it should identify, which should invoke. Okay, now let us try to see this. Okay, so let me go back to my directory. One minute. Let me go back to my directory by writing cd. Okay, now I have a pair written. GCC dash M32. Now we will take yesterday's code 220621.c. Okay. Now to show you which function gets executed, I need to see the object code. Correct, or rather the executable code. So whatever executable code that gets generated, I will see. I came from 1 to 10, now I am going from 10 to 1. Now in the reverse path, reverse engineering, what we call it as. In this reverse engineering, we need to find out who calls main. What I said? In the code, we have to find out who calls main. Okay, so how to do this? So reverse engineering utility called obj dump disassemble dash b a dot out pipeless. Okay, so it contains complete disassembled code of the binary or of the machine language. Okay, so this was the code generated. Now from this code, this is generated. Okay, so for every line. So let us go below. Okay, let us try to take this into a file. I will redirect this to p. Okay, so emacs p. Now let us try to search main. Somewhere main written, libc start main. Okay, let me go further. Libc start main. This is main. At three places I could see this main is called. So this is my original definition of main, and this main was called, this is disassembled, correct? And if I see now this function, can you see call here? Correct? So this is the function which gets executed at the part. Like if you may see, disassemble of section dot text. This is where your code starts. Your executable code, machine code, starts execution from text section. This is the executable code added in text section. And first function in text section contains definition of start. Fine. Now, if I am saying that this is the first function, I need to prove this. Fine. So, right now I am going to show you that part. In detail, we will be talking about it in next session. Fine. So, to achieve this goal, to show you this part, what I will do is, I will add some more information in my assembly code. Or sorry, in my C code. Instead of making changes in the C code, I will do what? I will add one parameter with the GCC. So, that is called as dash G. What is dash G does? Dash G adds in debugging information in an executable file. Okay, so let us see first this. What is size of a dot out? Check it. 15688. Now let me write dash G and let me check again file size. Nearly 1000 bytes are added. Nearly 1000, not exactly 1000, but nearly something like 800 plus are added bytes, correct? So this is added information in my code because of this dash G switch that I use at the time of generating the executable. So this dash G does what? Adds debug information for debugging purpose. So if user is trying to debug the code, which is to be done by most of us at the latest is when program fails to respond. Now your strategy, probably most of you might be using a strategy like this. Like when you see an error, runtime error in the code, you keep adding printfs and then you try to see where is the problem, correct? Instead of it, there are debuggers available. So on Linux, a standard debugger program is available called GDB, GNU Debugger. And that's what we are going to make use of. So what you do now, you created a file with debugging information. So for example, let me show you again by removing this. If I create a file, I know that size of file is lesser, okay, like this, 1.68. How can I verify whether this contains debugging information or not? So if I write gdb.slash/out, give your executable name there. Okay, when it's done, you may see that what it is telling us? No debugging symbols found in out. So I will write quit. So I will create this now .g. Again I will write gdb.read.out. Now you may see reading symbols from out. So that text was removed. Okay, now another thing. Let me open spreadsheet. Now see this code. The text that I am going to add. Let it open. Open like this. Yeah. We got it. Now assume that this is your code. So I am giving some background to this. Okay, and assume that each one of them is an executable statement. Now let us say this is a function call. Now what happens? When it starts execution from this, it moves to next, it moves to next, then it moves to next. It is sequential execution. When it reaches to this call, suppose this is XXX call, a function. Now this XXX is written here. What should happen? Control should pass from this to this. Now if this function body is like this, again containing few statements. So when it starts execution, when it reaches to this line XXX, control is passed to this XXX. It executes, and then when it, after the execution of these lines of XXX, it should return back to original code. How will it know that what is the return address? Right? What is the return address? How will I know that? So
there must be
I have to store information of every function call in the stack, and every operating system has a system stack. So if this is main also is a function. How many of you don't agree with me? Everyone must agree with me, or should agree with me, or may agree with me that yes, main is a function. If main is called, then ultimately there should be a stack associated with this main too. And this main is called by some function, say, from here. The main. Main is called and then it comes here. Control is here. Then control is here and so on. So how can I show you that part? So let us try to see how exactly it works. So let me write GDB. Okay. For that purpose, let me make the change. Emacs 2206.c. So now this is your ABC function. ABC PQR, another function that I am calling PQR printf ASDF. So this is my code. Main is calling ABC, ABC is calling PQR, and PQR is calling printf. But printf will be automatically executed because it is a system function. But ABC and PQR are my functions. Correct. So let us say this. Let us create executable. So we executed this code. So if I execute, you may see that ASDF is printed. But then how will I know that main intern called ABC, ABC intern called PQR, because that was our code. That was our code. Main calls ABC, ABC calls PQR, and PQR calls intern, which is a standard learning function. So I should be able to see this function packing. Okay. So let us generate this. Let us go to GDB. Now let me set the breakpoint from where the execution should start. So I am saying start at this point. Let me say run. So there is a, not necessary to remember the commands right now. We can discuss a bit later. I am only introducing you the stack part. So if I write BT, you may say this is a stack, backtrace. BT means backtrace. It is showing me that there is a stack of main. Now, what we said, probably we are starting execution from main. That's why it is showing only that stack. Okay. Now let me write next step. So it is here. So if I write BT again, it is still in the main. So if I write next, now it is going to execute this ABC. If I write BT, it is still in main. If I say next, now you may say it is in the same code and it is showing me that it is here. Correct. So if I write BT, again it is showing me directly return 0. Then where exactly my other things are? So if I say next step, I will start from your time. I pressed N. So step BT, step BT, step. Now you may see it is in ABC. I wrote M there, that's why it happened. So it was in main. Now control is passed to this ABC function. Now you can see line number also got changed. Now ABC is going to execute. So if I write BT, now see how many stacks are there. Now is it acting as a stack? Now at the top, ABC is there. Top of the stack, ABC is there. And below it, this is the function, main. So if I again say step, it is going to call PQR. So if I write BT, only two stacks still. Now PQR should get executed. So if I say step, now three functions are there. You can see now PQR is here. So if I write BT, you see the three stacks. These are the addresses where the item should be. So if I now write step, it is going to execute this printf. So BT. Step, it never shows us that it is executing that printf thing. Okay, because it is standard library function. It will execute through user's program. Hey, now if I write now it is in PQR, now it is going to execute this curly bracket, last curly bracket of PQR. So if I say step, it is back into ABC. So a stack is removed. Correct? Again step, stack is removed. Again step, now it should come out of main. Because curly bracket is still there, step for BT. Now see how many stacks are there. It came out of main, but now these are the two stacks. So libc start main is the function which calls main. And this libc start main is called by underscore start. Because at the bottom of the stack, like this is the top, correct? So this is like we saw with respect to order. This ABC was called by main. That's why main was at 1 and ABC was 0, because this is the top of the stack. So top of the stack is libc. So this should be called by somebody else. So it is called by underscore start. So this file contains this information that libc start main should find main in the code. So most of you who used TurboC compiler to compile their files, you must have seen that if you don't write main and if you try to generate an executable, it used to say undefined symbol main in c0s.obj file. Correct? So similar thing, like if you don't have that major, it is going to show you some error, not exactly the same but differently. So now, if somebody is asking you or anybody is asking you, what is the, which of the first function gets executed when you execute a C code? At execution level, underscore start is the function, but from C code, main is the first function. Listen carefully what I said. At execution level, underscore start is the first function, but at C level, C program level, main is the first function. Got it now? So if I say step again, it will terminate the code, and your code got print, it is printing this ASDM. Time? Understood? So now you quit from it. Understood the thing? So I'm not asking you to always say yes. Okay, you may say no. But like I'm going to upload this recorded session today now for all three lectures from first session, so that you can check again when your time what exactly we covered and try to grasp it. If you are not getting it, you can let me know. But whatever I am trying in the class, whatever I am trying to show you in the class, you should try at your home. So like you must have seen on 10 TV, but when it advertises WWE, it says don't try this at home. I always will say try this at home. Okay, you need to, otherwise it will be difficult for you to understand what I am trying to tell. Right? Okay, so see you in next class. If any questions are there, you can post probably in our WhatsApp group. And ask the students who are not attending the class to keep, please attend the classes regularly. Yeah, Rohit, you were saying something.
No.
Okay. So if you have any questions, you can ask me later because you will have class after 10 minutes. So let us take a break for you, people. Let me give a break for you. I am going to upload this recorded file on our Moodle course site. You can check it. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.